Hey guys, and welcome back to the Acne channel. My name is Lavinia Rosanda, and I'm also a content creator here on YouTube. Now today, we're going to be talking about four things that you should never put on your skin. And I'm definitely excited to get into this because I've seen a lot of people put certain foods or ingredients on their skin that I'm like, no, please don't do that. So we're gonna be breaking it down today, talking about why you shouldn't be putting these things on your face and why sometimes there is this misconception that these things do belong on your skin. So let's get right on into it. So there's a lot of beauty trends that come and go, but DIY skincare is one of those that seems to always be around and be very popular that I wish would just go away. And I really appreciate people trying to be creative with their skincare, but I think we should leave our creativity to other things and avoid these like at-home skincare treatments because really they can cause more damage than good. So first up, lemon. And let's talk about quickly why people even use lemon on their skin or are told to use lemon on their skin. So lemon does naturally contain vitamin C, which is an antioxidant. Our bodies naturally create it, and vitamin C is an amazing skincare ingredient applied topically to help with brightening the skin, to help with dark spots and hyperpigmentation, and also boost your SPF even, and kind of fight off that free radical damage and stressors in your environment. And on top of that, it can be anti-inflammatory and even antibacterial. So overall, great ingredient. So vitamin C has all these great traits to it, and you can find it in lemons, but why should you not put lemons on your face? So lemons are extremely acidic, which can lead to irritation, sensitivity, and even dry out your skin, or even worse, cause like extreme redness or even peeling of the skin. Overall, I definitely think you should stick to a stabilized form of vitamin C that you know was made by chemists who know how to formulate these skincare products so that it's safe and effective for your skin, and kind of avoid using lemons on your face and use them to make some delicious lemonade. And that's simply because a vitamin C serum will have a set concentration of vitamin C that is safe to use on your face, as well as manufacturer instructions on how to use these products and how to make sure that you're using them correctly and not damaging your skin. Now, although lemons do contain that vitamin C, they're also a citrus fruit. So citrus and sunlight can often lead to a bad skin reaction, which can cause that peeling, burning, blister, swelling of the skin, and really just make your skin a lot worse than just using a vitamin C serum. If you want the benefits of vitamin C, just go grab a serum. The BANISH oil is a great one to look at, or the BANISH vitamin C cream are some of my favorites. There's so many out there to choose from, and you definitely don't have to use a lemon. Next up, toothpaste. Now, this is another super popular one, especially for all the acne warriors out there. I am sure that all of you have at least once in your life tried toothpaste on your acne. I know I for sure have, because when I was a teenager and had a full face of acne, that's what everyone was telling me to use. And fast forward 7 years later, I'm now in my early 20s, and I know that is not the best thing to do. So toothpaste contains those ingredients that can help clean the bacteria in your mouth, but those ingredients are not necessarily great for the skin. I have seen toothpaste recommended as an overnight spot treatment where you just dab a little bit onto your pimple, let it sit overnight, and hope for the best in the morning. And every time I see toothpaste used as an acne or acne scar treatment, it makes me go crazy. And basically, the whole like mentality behind this is because some toothpaste does contain triclosan, which does kill bacteria. And many people think, okay, if it kills bacteria, it can also kill acne bacteria. Similar to this, people also use baking soda, hydrogen peroxide, and even alcohol, which these ingredients can be found in toothpaste to shrink and kind of make that pimple go away faster. And aside from that, menthol is also a common ingredient in toothpaste, kind of giving you that minty sensation. And oftentimes that can help with acne pain because it will kind of give you that numb, tingly feeling, but you definitely should not be using toothpaste for your acne. Overall, your skin is way too sensitive for you to be putting toothpaste on, and toothpaste does have a basic pH, so a lower pH, and our skin is naturally acidic, so that'll kind of just throw the pH of your skin out of whack. And aside from that, most toothpaste do contain sodium lauryl sulfate, SLS, which most people avoid in skincare. And if you look at a lot of skincare products, let's say more of that clean beauty skincare, you will see that usually they're fragrance free, don't contain alcohol, and do not contain SLS. So if you're one of those people who like to look at more of those DIY skincare solutions because they're more natural, you're probably the same person who's looking to make sure your skincare doesn't have SLS. So make sure you're not using toothpaste on your acne, please, I beg you. This will just cause dryness, irritation, and overall can just make the situation a lot worse or not even work on your acne. There are so many better acne treatments out there that are specifically made to help your acne, like the BANISH Fighter Gel. That one is one of my favorites. It's not irritating to the skin. It's safe for sensitive skin, even eczema and rosacea. So definitely look for something like that instead of your toothpaste. Next up, vinegar, specifically apple cider vinegar. Now, apple cider vinegar does contain anti-inflammatory properties, as it does consist of acetic acid and AHAs, alpha hydroxy acids, which can help exfoliate the skin, unclog pores, and absorb excess oil and sebum on the skin. But again, acidity can burn and irritate the skin, and there are so many amazing AHA exfoliants out there that are specifically formulated for your skin and for your skin to handle. One of my favorites is the BANISH Pumpkin Enzyme Mask that contains AHAs such as glycolic acid, and that one is one of my favorites. It's really great for sensitive skin or dry skin as well, and helps with my acne too. So there are definitely way better options out there that you can make sure your skin won't have adverse reactions to. I personally love apple cider vinegar in my salad, and that's where I'm going to keep it because I do not want to risk a chemical burn. And the last ingredient we're going to be talking about today is eggs, and more particularly egg whites is really what I've been seeing. Now, a lot of the claims are that egg whites can actually help smooth and tighten your skin and pores if used as a facial mask. And I don't know about this one. I feel like if you're using it as a mask, any potential benefits you might see from this tightening of your pores from eggs would be washed off in like 10 minutes anyways. So like, is it really gonna do anything if you're only leaving it on for a short amount of time? But then again, I wouldn't wanna leave it on for too long either. So honestly, I just think this idea should be ditched. Worst case scenario is you're using raw eggs, so salmonella, especially if you're applying this around the mouth area, or you have a localized skin infection, which is also possible to get infection through, like an open wound or something. So overall, I think there are way better ingredients that are specifically used for skincare and that can help it smooth out your skin and give you that tighter appearance. There's lots of toners and different serums out there that can really help with that and work effectively on your skin. So please, let's keep our eggs for our morning omelets and off our faces. So really, what was the conclusion of this video? You know, wake up, brush your teeth with some toothpaste, go make your omelet, you know, and then later in the day, have some lemonade out of your lemons and put some apple cider vinegar on your salad. But the key lesson is don't put any of these things on your face. You can have a great skincare routine that's really effective and is gonna be safe for your skin, and you can really just avoid these DIY at-home skin concoctions that can end up damaging your skin more than you need to. So I hope this video was helpful. Hopefully it was a day of realization, because I know we've all tried these DIY skincare treatments before, and hopefully you'll have no more of that in your skincare routine. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so, so much for watching. I hope you're having a fantastic day or night, and make sure to subscribe to the Acne channel and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Hope you're having a fantastic day or night whenever you're watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye.